This screencast demonstrates how to use the interactive simulation for a compressibility factor chart. And what this chart is a plot of compressibility factor, pressure times volume divided by the ideal gas constant, absolute temperature. The other way you can look at this compressibility factor is that Z is equal to the volume of the actual real gas divided by the volume that an ideal gas would occupy at the same temperature and pressure. Now, this plot has on the x-axis the reduced pressure, namely the pressure divided by the critical pressure for that particular gas. And then as a parameter, a number of curves are shown corresponding to different reduced temperatures, where reduced temperature is defined in a similar manner as the temperature over the critical temperature, both of these temperatures being in absolute degrees, you know, degrees Kelvin, for example. And the simulation then shows a green line that corresponds to an ideal gas. So for an ideal gas, the compressibility factor is 1. Again, you can see that the compressibility factor deviates from 1. It deviates more as we go to lower temperatures. And we also see that if the pressure is low enough, then we approach ideal gas behavior. Namely, if the molecules are far enough apart that they don't interact, then the compressibility factor is 1, and that's what we see down here. Now, the reason we're showing and using the compressibility factor is it demonstrates one, the idea of corresponding states, that if we plot compressibility factor versus reduced variables, in this case reduced pressure and for different reduced temperatures, then the plots look very similar for different molecules, but they're not identical. And so in this simulation, we show charts for 5 molecules. So at lower temperatures, reduced temperature of 1, for example, there's significant deviation from ideal gas behavior. This is due to the fact there's attractive interactions between molecules. And then as we raise the temperatures, these attractive interactions are reduced. But the attractive interactions cause the compressibility factor to be less than 1. Namely, the volume is less than the volume we would expect for an ideal gas because of these attractive interactions. If we go to high enough pressures and temperatures, high enough reduced pressures and reduced temperatures, the compressibility factor can be greater than 1. And this is due to the fact that now repulsive interactions become important. And so the volume can be greater than what we expect from ideal gas calculations because molecules occupy space and they start repelling each other. So let's look at the interactive simulation to see this behavior for the different molecules. Here's the interactive simulation. And the first thing to note is that we can move the black dot. So you use a mouse to change the critical pressure and critical temperature. And then it'll read off the value of the compressibility factor at that condition. We can also look at different molecules. So in hexane compared to hydrogen, you notice for hydrogen, over this range, the compressibility factor is less than 1. Likewise for nitrogen, as we get to bigger molecules, then the compressibility factor at the higher pressures is greater than 1 at the high reduced temperatures. The other thing to notice is then the charts are different for each molecule. And so in books, you often find 2 sets of charts. So to get the compressibility factor, you read a value off from each. And for one of them, you multiply the value by the eccentric factor, and you combine the 2 terms to get a more accurate value from a generalized compressibility chart. Because otherwise, you'll have to do what we do here and have a different chart for each molecule.